with which we can solve problems, and we revisit.
We've covered a lot of different data structures, or we're starting to cover a lot of different data structures at this point, and we the one that students are most familiar with by this point is arrays, but arrays, they're great to get started with, but they definitely suffer from a few major flaws, in particular the fact that they are fixed size and can only hold elements of one type, at least in a language like C.
Indeed, and you have to know, of course, a priori how big of an array you want, otherwise you have to like manually reallocate it and repopulate it or copy everything over. So this is actually one of our first, well, one of many, but one of our best, I think, opportunities in class to really start discussing deeply trade-offs and having students critically think about what an array is good for, what it's bad for, and what kind of ceiling you bump up against ultimately with this data structure when it comes to solving more sophisticated problems. Like the goal here is without just saying, hey, there's these other data structures in the world like linked lists or trees or whatnot, what are the problems with what we have so as to actually motivate solving the problem?
Right. Yeah, I would say that, at least in my opinion, week five is really the week where we start to focus a lot more on design, or encouraging students to think a little more critically about design.
And it's an opportunity to, I mean, yeah, really start to use as building blocks pointers and a basic understanding of memory management to start to sort of stitch together our own things in memory. And this is actually one of the reasons that I like C so much, is that we have this ability, albeit at a low level, which can be a little scary and a little difficult to grok at first, but we have this ability to create out of memory anything we want. And so only those data structures we ourselves design and then implement do we have at our disposal.
Right, something that students can take for granted later on when they use a language like PHP or Python, that things like hash tables are just given to them for free by virtue of using that language. Here they get to see what it's like behind the scenes at the very low level, which really only C, among languages that are frequently used today, really only C that gives us the chance to really take that.
Agreed.
That peek.
And it allows us to continue the conversation too about abstraction, in that with an array, we can ultimately build other things even using that data structure. Eventually we'll talk about like stacks and queues, which could be implemented more dynamically with linked lists, but they could also be implemented fairly with fairly fixed sizes using an array, and yet you can therefore abstract away the inside of a stack or queue might indeed be an array, but there too it's an opportunity to understand what the limitations or implications of that design decision are, especially if it's the easier of the two design decisions. As soon as you take out your text editor and have to start stitching things together with pointers, there's a bit more effort involved.